Today's scripture is taken from Exodus 14, verses 13 and 14 from the NKJV. And Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall see again no more forever. The Lord will fight for you, and you shall hold your peace." Brethren, I'm sure many of you may have heard and read this portion of scripture where Moses was leading the Israelites out of 430 years of bondage in Egypt. And God had brought 10 different types of plagues upon the Egyptians because of Pharaoh's refusal to let God's people go. But after they made good their escape, Pharaoh began to pursue them, to recapture them. And the Israelites became, you could say, sandwiched between the Red Sea and on the one hand, and the Egyptians coming after them on the other. And what were they to do? It looked as though their number was up. But the Lord was on their side. And the scripture reading is what Moses said to them. And beloved, as children of the same God of Israel, when we are faced with impossible situations, trials and tribulations, sickness and the ravages of this pandemic, know that our Father is on our side. He fights our battles. We need not be afraid. He will save us. And we see throughout scripture, he has been telling his children, do not fear. And how do we claim faith rather than fear? Well, according to the Christian Broadcasting Network, here are 5 out of 10 ways we can do this. 1, by guarding our hearts. Proverbs 4:23 says, "Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it spring the issues of life." When the enemy tries to sow seeds of fear, worry, anxiety, rebuke them instantly and replace them with God's fruit of the Spirit, love, joy, kindness, and so forth. We must bring every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. 2 Corinthians 10:5b. Replace negative thoughts with a life-giving one from God's Word. 3, we need to rejoice always. Pray without ceasing and in everything give thanks. 1 Thessalonians 5:16-18. We can move from fear to faith by praising and thanking God in prayer. 4, we must read our Bibles. Hebrews 4:12 tells us the Word of God is living and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit and of joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. During these times of stress, the promises of God are very reassuring and provide strength and encouragement. 5, we should stay in community. Hebrews 10:25 tells us not to forsake the assembling of ourselves together, but to exhort one another, especially as we see the day approaching. Brethren, let us not isolate ourselves. Let us connect, whether we go to church physically, whether we connect virtually, pick up the phone, talk to your brethren. Let us encourage and lift up one another. Amen. In closing, let us not allow fear to overcome us. Let us keep our hearts, our minds, our souls and spirits fixed upon Christ at all times. Jesus loves you. Have a wonderful day, brethren.